Hello, dear students. I am Dr. Mahesh Nakes. And in this particular session or video, we are discussing the Model Millionaire written by Oscar Wilde. And this is a prose in English language. And this is class one. That means here in this class or in this video, I am not going to discuss the entire story, the Model Millionaire, but a part or section of the story I am going to discuss. Okay, my dear students. So let us see. Oscar Wilde, his lifetime is 1854 to 1900, and these two are the pictures of the writer Oscar Wilde. My dear students, you might have read stories or poems or even plays on different themes in your PUC or in your previous classes. And those stories or poems are placed maybe on different themes like love, poverty, patriotism, sacrifice, humanity, etc. And the writers who wrote those stories or poems or plays are definitely from different countries. The objectives of this class is, dear students, to make you know about the writer Oscar Wilde. That means in this video, you know some information about the writer and his writings. And there is another objective, to make you understand difficulties of joblessness, particularly to young men. Let us have a look at the writer Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde was born on 16 October 1854 in Dublin, that is in Ireland. So obviously he was an Irish poet as well as a playwright. Playwright means one who writes plays, nataka, darita kanta, vyakti. And here we have a list of some important works by Oscar Wilde. The Happy Prince and Other Stories, A House of Pomegranates. These are the collection of fairy tales. These are the collection of, these two books are collection of fairy tales. Of course, there are many other books in which there are many stories. And The Woman of No Importance, An Ideal Husband. These two are plays. These two are plays, dramas written by this writer. The Ballad of Reading Gaul, The Sphinx. These are the poems, because we said he was a poet also. So he wrote poems also. And he died on 30 November 1900. Right, so we learned some information about the writer. Now let us go to the story. Okay, so some basic information, or we can say introduction about the story. Yes, what we have in the introduction means, this story was first appeared in the newspaper, The World, in 1887. Andre modalu ee story publish aaginta munche newspaper alli bandirutte. The title of the newspaper is The World. And then Again, it was published in 1891 as part of the anthology Lord Arthur Savile's Crime and Other Stories. So this is the title of the book, and anthology means it is a collection of different proses or stories or poems or plays. It is a collection. So in this collection, Lord Arthur Savile's Crime and Other Stories, this story, particular story, The Model Millionaire, was published in 1891. Yes, so what is this story about, if you think like that? Okay, yes, this story is about a young man's love, his generosity, and the river he had. Okay, and the important characters, the main characters in this story we are going to meet are, one, Hughie Erskine, we can call him as a protagonist or the main character, then Laura Merton, and the Colonel Alan Trevor, a beggar man. These are the important characters we meet in the story. Now let us have a look at the explanation of the story, dear students. Fine, the story begins with some observations of the writer. The writer feels or thinks that there is no use of being a charming fellow if one is not wealthy. That means, even though you are attractive, even though you are charming, if you do not have money, according to the writer, there is no value or no use. Rupa eshte chanagidru saha, eshte saundarya idru saha, manushyana hatra hana illa andre yavade upayoga illa annodu ee writer na abhipraya. Right. Romance is the privilege of the rich, not of the unemployed or the poor. So romance means maybe, okay, falling in love or dreaming about something related to love or young girls or boys. So eeritiya vicharagalanna we can call as romance. That means here the writer feels for the unemployed. Okay, so the unemployed people should not think or dream about romance or such love feelings. Okay, they should not have feelings regarding love. So if you have to think or dream about love or romance, means you should be rich. Rich people can only do such things, another writer's opinion. Yeah, so the poor should be practical and prosaic. The poor should be practical, okay? So they should know how they are and what is their economical condition. They should not think or dream. They should not be poetical or romantic, okay? Because that needs money. If you don't have money, okay, no girl is going to be attracted by you, or of course, father is ready to give his daughter in marriage to such persons who do not have money, another the writer's opinion. It is better to have a permanent income. Okay, according to the writer, especially a man should have a permanent income, source of income. Hana galike irbeku, arthika ondu moola avanige irbeku. That means he should have money, permanent. But unfortunately, Hughie Erskine, the protagonist or the main character, never realized these truths. Even if he satya gottirilla yav satya idan mele la helidvala, okay, one should have permanent income, one should have employment, one should be rich to think about romance or love anadu, he did not know. Gottirilla Hughie Erskine yenagittu gottilde idre. So what is wrong if he doesn't know? Okay, let us see. Poor Hughie never said a brilliant or ill-natured thing in his life. Of course, poor means both economically and his condition. Okay, the poet feels he's a poor. Ayyo antivala, ayyo anorthadalli, ayyo papa anorthadalli irthilla, papa da Hughie, papa da huduga anta irthilla. So of course, a good natured young man, Hughie Erskine, of course, he never said a brilliant speech or brilliant words. At the same time, he did not even speak ill-natured things, bad things in life. ಅವನು ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಬುದ್ಧಿವಂತಿಕೆ ಮಾತು ಆಡದೇ ಇದ್ರೂ ಸಹ ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಸಹ ಅವನು ಯಾರಿಗೂ ತನ್ನ ಜೀವನದಲ್ಲಿ ಆಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅಥವಾ ಹೇಳಿಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋದು ರೈಟರ್ಸ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್. ಎಸ್, ಸಮ್ ಇನ್ಫಾರ್ಮೇಶನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಟಾಗನಿಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯೂಯರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಅಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಪ್. ಚಾಪ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಫೆಲೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಚಾಪ್, ಗುಡ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಫೆಲೋ, ಗುಡ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. How he is good looking? Okay, he has crisp brown hair. Crisp means tight, curly, not really curly, tight brown hair and clear cut profile. His physique, okay, dahikavagi nodidre clear cut, okay, attractive, charming and helpful, aariti, with gray eyes. That means in short, Hugh Erickson is a very nice looking person. Fine, even though, okay, so he did not have money, he was very popular with men and women, of course, but had no money. Hana irlila avanatra, adre he was popular with men and women. Okay, they generally liked him because of his appearance and good nature. ರೈಟ್, ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ನೋ ಮನಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಹಣ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ ಅಥವಾ ಏನಿತ್ತು ಅವನ ಹತ್ರ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಸೀ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹೌ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್, ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಲೈವ್ಲಿಹುಡ್ ಅಂತ ನೋಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ, ರೈಟ್, ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಿಕ್ವಿತ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪೆನಿನ್ಸುಲರ್ ವಾರ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬುಕ್. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಬಿಕ್ವಿತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎಂಡೋ ವಿತ್. ನಾವು ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಬಳುವಳಿಯಾಗಿ ಬಂದಿದ್ದು, ತಂದೆಯಿಂದ ಮಗನಿಗೆ ಬಂದಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಹ್ಯೂಯಿಯ ತಂದೆಯಿಂದ ಮಗನಿಂದ ತನಗೆ ಏನು ಬಂದಿದೆ ಹ್ಯೂಯಿಗೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಸೋರ್ಡ್. ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಫೈಟ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಅಶ್ವದಳ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ, ಅಶ್ವದಳ ಅಂದರೆ ಕುದುರೆ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋರಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಸೈನಿಕರು ಬಳಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂತಹ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ಗೆ ಕತ್ತಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ. ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಸೋಲ್ಜರ್ಸ್ ಹೂ fight on horseback. Maybe it seems maybe his father was in cavalry or somehow he had a sword, cavalry sword. Adar jothege his father had left for him, given him history of the Peninsular War, okay, book. It is a book. Fine, of course these two things do not fetch any income. Yavde aadayagalilla barodilla. ಹಾಗೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದ ಇವನ್ನ, ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಬುಕ್? ಯಸ್, ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಹಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ದ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ಲಾಸ್. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಕ್ಯಾವಲ್ರಿ ಸೋರ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ತನ್ನ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ತೂಗು ಹಾಕಿದ್ದ, ತಾನು ನೋಡ್ತೇವಂತ ಕನ್ನಡಿಯ ಮುಂದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಕೆಪ್ಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಅದರ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಶೆಲ್ಫ್. ಈ ಬುಕ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇನ್ನು ಎರಡು ಪುಸ್ತಕಗಳ ನಡುವೆ ಶೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದ. ಓಕೆ, ಅದಷ್ಟೇ ಮಾತ್ರ ಉಪಯೋಗ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಹಿಮ್. ರೈಟ್, ಫೈನ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫಾರ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿದೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಹಣ ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ತನ್ನ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ. ಹಿ ಲಿವ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಎ £200 ಎ ಇಯರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಸ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಮನಿ, ಹೌ ಮೀನ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಮನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹಿಸ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಆಂಟ್ gave him £200 a year. ಒಂದ್ ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ 200 pounds ಹ್ಯೂಯಿಗೆ ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲಂತೆ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಆಂಟ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್. ಸೊ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಮನಿ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್. ಆ ಹಣದಿಂದ ತನ್ನ ಜೀವನವನ್ನು ಸಾಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದ. ದೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಎ ಯಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್, ಒಬ್ಬ ಯುವಕ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಡಿಡಂಟ್ ಯು ಟ್ರೈ ಎನಿ ಜಾಬ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಷನ್, ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಪಡಲಿಲ್ವಾ? Did he only live on the money given by his old aunt and the yoshu madadre? No, my dear students, he tried some professions or some business like things. Like he spent some money in the stock exchange jalli swalpa hanavanna todagistane. Okay, for 6 months he tried to invest money and get profit in stock exchange, but he did not gain any profit, because stock exchange, okay, we whenever the stock exchange term comes to our mind, we think of the terms bulls and bears. Bulls and bears. So anta bulls and bears, he was just like a butterfly. The writer says the same thing. Okay, he was like a butterfly between the bulls and bears, okay, who are there in the stock exchange. He was an inexperienced person who had no experience regarding spending money. So he found no success there. Right. Then he tried to as a tea merchant, and even he sold dry sherry. Sherry means dry wine. He tried to sell dry wine, he tried to sell tea, but no use, no success followed him. He did not gain any success or profit in these professions. Yeah, no profession, but a perfect profile. Perfect profile. Kelsa ilde idru saha, udyoga ilde idru saha, okay, nododak matra tumba aakarshikavagi kaanta idda, gunadalli saha ashte sambhavitanagida. Okay, so character wise and looking physically, he was a good looking person, but no profession, and of course no profession, no money, dear students. Right, so far we knew so many things about Huey Erickson, about his physical appearance and of course his economical condition. To make the matter worse, or unfortunately we can say, at this moment he loved Laura Merton. He was in love with a girl, Laura Merton. Avanige udyoga illa, hana illa, idra jothege Laura Merton anno hudigiyanna, yuvatiyanna, okay, he loved. So who is this Laura Merton anta yoshne madidre, she was a daughter of a retired colonel. Okay, so this colonel was a short-tempered man. Okay, and even he had health issues. Okay, so aarogyada swalpa samasye irthakanta vyakti matte swalpa short-tempered begane sitikoltakanta vyakti, this retired colonel. Right, so how these two young lovers feeling anta nodadre, both adored each other. Yeah, of course loved each other, there is no doubt. Adored means love and respect deeply. Okay, not only love, adored means love and respect deeply. They were deeply in love, at the same time they respected each other. Even the writer says Huey was ready to kiss Laura's shoestrings. Laura shoe idavala, aa shoe na strings andre eno dara kattodidiyala adannu kuda kiss madodakku sa ready agidnante, ashtondu pritistha idda annodu. Okay, the writer says through that sentence, dear students. Fine, many people knew about their love affair, and because they were the handsomest couple in London, anta writer heltaru. Okay, thumba ibru sa handsomest couple. Okay, of course she was beautiful and he was handsomest couple in London, entire London. But my dear students, not a penny. Ibratra sa hana annodu irlilla, and of course to lead a life we need money. Fine, what about the colonel, Laura's father bagi yoshne madodre, what he was thinking about Huey, whether he was ready to give his daughter in marriage to Huey another day. Yeah, fine, this colonel liked Huey. Okay, ishta padta idda, okay, olle huduga anta. But when it comes to engagement or marriage, this colonel would keep quiet. Yenu maatadta irilla. Okay, but anyhow, this colonel put a demand for £10,000. This colonel says to Huey, okay, you bring or you earn £10,000, and then let us see or let us think about the marriage. Ee rithiya ondu condition anna haaktane. Yes, but yeah, of course we know that it is very difficult for Huey to bring 10,000 pounds. Whenever this colonel talked about or referred to this 10,000 pounds, he would become gloomy, sad. Okay, tumba dukha aagtittu, besara aagtittu. Then he would go to Lara for consolation. Avanige samadhana padisodakke, samadhana tagedukolladakke Lara hatra hogi tanna dukhavanna helikolta idda. Lara Merton, yeah, his beloved. Fine, dear students, one day Huey was walking through the Holland Park. Holland Park, there is an area where the Lara Merton with her father lived. Lara Merton vasavagirthakanta area Holland Park iruttala alli hogta irthane, and on the way Huey visits Alan Trevor. Alan Trevor anna obba vyaktiyanna visit martane, hogi bheti aagtane. And who is this Alan Trevor? A painter, an artist. Excuse me. He was a painter, an artist, and of course a friend of Huey. Huey a gelaya hagu painter agirthakanta, painter means artist kalegarana agirthakanta Alan Trevor hatra hogtane. Right now, how this Trevor, painter, artist ant helidivi, okay, artist ant helidivi kalavida, right, how he was rough fellow. He was a rough fellow. Look, nodidre sapa rough kaanta idda, with freckled face. Freckled means brown patches on the skin due to the exposure of skin to the sun. Suryanalli belakige athwa bisilige jaasti odaadadaga aa mukhada mele sapa brown patches aagtavalla anta mukhakke naavu freckled face anta karithivi. Right, red ragged beard. What is this ragged means? This is not maintained clearly or uniformly. Ashtu neat aagi illade irthakkantaha svalpa clumsy aagi kaanta irthakkantaha gadda avanige ittu. Okay, not uniformly maintained athwa imperfect beard. Okay, so intha vyakti athwa ee tara kaanta irthakkantha vyakti this Alan Trevor. But kaanodakke athra irabodu. Okay, he may be looking rough or freckled with a neglected beard, but if he holds the brush to paint, okay, he is a master with the brush. Bariyodakke chitravana bariyodakke paint brush na thonda andre avana meersoru irlilla anno arthadalli. Okay, so he was a master in painting, such a good artist he was. And of course there was a lot of demand for his pictures, for his paintings. Okay, so for his paintings lot of demands, but demand it on paintings to tholta idru jana bandu tama paintings na baraskolta idru. So this kind of demand he had. Right, so this Trevor was attracted by Huey's personal charm. So Huey a personal charm, okay, on a note bitu he was attracted. Yeah, so generally my dear students, artists are attracted by beauty. Kalavidaru athwa kale bagge aasakti irthakantavaru saundaryavanna nodida takshana adu aakarshakaragutare. Adu saundarya yavade tarada saundarya aagirabodu, adu nadi irabodu, yavade ondu kattada irabodu, athwa yavade ondu prakruti irabodu. Okay, right, so we know that he was a good looking person. He was attracted towards him. According to Trevor, okay, Trevor has some opinion regarding people. General bagge some opinion ide. Let us see what opinion he had anadu Alan Trevor. Yeah, according to him, painters like yarana ishtapadtare, people who are artistic pleasure to look at and intellectual repose to talk. That means, okay, people who are artistic pleasure to look at northa idre janagalanna. Okay, those people, if you look at them, they should create a pleasure in us. Okay, just like when we look a river, when we look a historical building like Taj Mahal, hege adar kade aakarshitaraagtivo aa reetiya artistic pleasure anna undumartakanta vyaktigalu, okay, vyaktigalu painters ge ishta aagtare. And even intellectual repose means, okay, so a kind of composure, that means you can trust them intellectually. So adike intellectual repose andre maatadta idre khushi kodtakanta santosha kodtakanta vyaktigalu painters ge ishta aagtare. That means painters like people who give or who create a kind of pleasure in the onlookers. okay, and people with whom you feel that okay, you want to talk more. Innu maatadabeku innu nodabeku anna vyaktigalu iruttaralla antha vyaktigalanna painters like maartara anta his opinion. And right, again one more opinion he has regarding people, men who are dandy and women who are darlings rule the world, at least okay, they should. Yeah, so he feels that dandy means men or man who cares too much about his clothes and appearance, tanna vesha bhushana tanna batte athwa tanhe kaanti nanadra batte jaasti gamanavana haristaralla antha vyaktigalu. And women who are darlings, darlings means good looking attractive women, they should rule the world ante antha janaru prapanchavana aalbeku anta his opinion. Okay, his opinion, let us not think more about his opinion. Right, there is one more reason why this Trevor liked Huey. And yes, Trevor liked Huey for his buoyant spirits and generous reckless nature. Yes, buoyant spirits, very light hearted and cheerful, tumba haguravada ondu manasulla vyakti andre mukta manasu athwa mugda manasu we can say. And cheerful, okay, he was always cheerful, buoyant, always cheerful. And generous reckless nature, generous means okay, dharala ant helthira, so giving in plenty whatever you have, ninna idrada ellavanna kodtakkantadu athwa iradralli balashtanu beredre kodtivala dharala guna iruttakkanta vyakti. But reckless nature, what is this reckless? Reckless means okay, so no thinking or no thought about the consequences, munde yen aagutte annodanna yojane maadadalli iruttakkanta ondu swabhava iruttala adana reckless ant helthivi. My dear students, sometimes we use the word reckless driving, reckless riding ant helthivalla andre munde accident aagutto athwa yen aagutto tondre aagutto yavudanna yojane maadadalli drive maartaralla adu reckless antakkantadu. That means here Huey was a person with cheerful spirits, cheerful attitude and very generous. Irodanella kottibidida munde yenadru agli anno arthadalli. Right, that is one more reason for Trevor's liking Huey. Fine art, so that because of this reason Trevor had given a open entry permission to enter his studio, artist studio, anytime yav bekaru barabodu yav bekaru holbodu ashton swatantravana Trevor nama Huey ge kottidda. Right, so when Huey enters the studio, so just I told you that Huey is visiting visits his friend and painter Trevor. Yes, bandaga yen maartta idda Trevor, when Huey enters the studio, that means that painting studio, Trevor was painting a life size picture of a beggar man. Yes, Trevor was in his profession, he is busy in painting a life size. The life size manusha eshtu udda iddana eshtu etra iddana ashtu full size ant helthivala adu. So yara picture ana he is painting of a beggar man. So that means there is a beggar man standing on the raised platform, raised plus sulpa raised like platform ide adar mele oba beggar man nintidane avana full size chitravanna okay he is painting. If a beggar man was standing there on the raised platform and this Huey is painting his picture. Right, how is this beggar man looking? The beggar man was a wizened old man, okay, dried up and wrinkled skin, dried up and wrinkled skin iltakanta tumba sukku gattida charma iltakanta vyakti this old man beggar, with a wrinkled face. Yeah, wrinkled, sukku gattida charma, sukku gattida mukha, and piteous expression. Okay, so if anybody looks at him, okay, one should feel ayyo, okay, it should very pity about him, ayyo anta anusutala, ayyo papa thon norra pantula arthadalli aa rithiya expression was there in the face of that beggar. Yes, and this beggar man had a coarse brown cloak on his shoulders. Coarse means rough, worn agirthakanta gatti agirthakanta brown cloak. Brown cloak means a sleeveless piece of cloth, okay, so generally hung on the shoulders, hige hegal mele hakoltakanta sleeveless piece of cloth we call as cloak adide, and that is very rough. The patched thick boots, patched means stitched, okay, alali patch agide, stitched and cobbled thick boots, okay, he's wearing, and a stick in one hand. Okay, in one hand he holds the stick and leaning against it, okay, supporting it, he's holding the stick in one hand, and in the other hand, a battered hat. Okay, he's holding battered means okay, shapeless, out of shape, we can say, because of excessive use. ಬಹಳ 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 ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ನಂತರ ದ ಶೇಪ್ಲೆಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಆ ರೀತಿ ಹ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಈಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಆರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ, ಭಿಕ್ಷೆಯನ್ನು ಬೇಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂತಾರಲ್ಲ ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಪೋಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಹಿ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್. ಒನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟರ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಟ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸಮ್ ಆರ್ಮ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್, ALMS ಆರ್ಮ್ಸ್. Okay, dear students, here let me stop this story. Okay, ivandu bhagadalli naavu nilisonante. In the next class also we'll be continuing this story. Now right, let us look at this multiple choice questions. One, yeah, the question is one. Yeah, so this also shows how much you have understood the story so far, my dear students. Oscar Wilde is an a writer. Yes, the first option, American writer, African writer, Canadian writer, Irish writer. Yes, dear students, think about the right answer, and here you have the right answer. Yes, Irish writer. Oscar Wilde is an Irish writer. Good. Question number two comes for you, dear students. Of the story The Model Millionaire first appeared in A, 1871, B, 1887, C, 1891, D, 1897. Yes, keep on thinking, dear students. And here comes the answer for you. B, yes, 1887 first appeared in that newspaper, The World. Question number three, let us see what it reads. According to Oscar Wilde, romance is the privilege of A, the rich, B, the poor, C, the educated, D, everyone. Yes, think about the answer. Yes, we have discussed all these things. And right, you are right, my dear students. It is the privilege of the rich. Let us move to the next question. And the next question is coming from the bottom right. Which one of the following is not true about Huey? Yes, not true about Huey. Excuse me, students. He had crisp brown hair. B, he had sold the cavalry sword given by his father. C, he was popular both with men and women. D, he was not successful as a tea merchant. Right, which is not true. Okay, not true. One is not true, other three are true about you. Yes, dear students, look at the answer. B, yes, he had sold the cavalry sword given by his father. This is not true about Huey. Fine. Question number five, yes. Who was Trevor? And the answers are here. I mean, options are here. A painter, a friend of Huey, only a painter, only B, only a friend of Huey, and E, both A and B, that means he was a painter and a friend of Huey. Okay, only a painter, only friend of Huey. What is this? That means, which is the right answer? Yes, answer E, both A and B, that means he was a painter as well as a friend of Huey. Right, dear students, here ends this question, multiple choice question session. And let us look at the references. These are the three links that have been used for the images and some information and the book Literary Landmarks to prepare this video session. And thank you, students, for listening to this class or watching this video. So keep smiling until we come back. Now let me close the class. I hope you have understood very well this story. So when we meet in the next class, definitely we will be continuing the remaining part of the story. Okay, now let me